Welcome back to another Humble Beach podcast. We're doing something a little different today. We're going on the road for the Meat Missile playoffs. So stay tuned. I hope you guys enjoy.
It's working. And we're off.
Yeah, so it's been an eventful weekend so far. I was going to ask Z if you wanted to golf with us.
Oh, shit. Is he available or
not? He's not. He works tonight. And he has to go in at 5. He ain't gonna make it.
Goddamn.
Tried to get him to call off, maybe. Like, dude, just say, fuck it, call off. But it's like, I like money. I'm like, I get it.
Who else can we get?
You got Swin's number?
I don't.
I'm trying to find someone comparable to, like, replacing.
Andy did offer up his cousin.
I don't want to do that. I like him. Good guy. But in a scramble format, it's almost like he doesn't play well.
Yeah.
Like, he was on a scramble team that I put together once, and I think we took, it was 18 holes at Westford, I think we took like 3 of his shots. Because someone always had a better shot. Like, he has no pressure to hit a good shot, so he just ends up not hitting a good shot.
I get that. I mean, I'm kind of dealing with that myself. Like, my average game is really bad now.
Yeah, like, when I'm in a scramble, that's where I kind of, I'm better in a scramble format. Because if I know, like, hey, I don't have to hit a good shot, I tend to hit a better shot because I don't think about having to hit a good shot.
Yeah. So are we skipping the podcast, or me and you just going to throw one together?
In fairness, I mean, we could probably still do the podcast with Andy. We just have to go over his house.
Well, that's fine. We use these mics and...
Yeah.
Well, don't you want to do that, though?
Yes, I don't...
I guess it'd be up to him since it's his house.
Yeah, and then at the same time, like, we're going to be probably on a bit of a time crunch.
Yeah.
Because we got... I would like to get to Wyandotte, you know, around 1 o'clock still to...
So we can play.
Even if, like, all I'm doing is hitting the chipping green and working on chips.
Yeah, yeah.
I would still rather do that if we don't have to get there at 1, but I'm just going to hit the chipping green, but... I would like to take a couple cuts with the fucking driver, you know,
for sure.
Loosen up the back a little bit.
Absolutely, it's cold. Yeah,
it's a little cold, and it's going to be colder in Wyandotte. Like, I checked.
It's going to rain.
It's like, oh, it's going to be 64 in Wyandotte when you're golfing. I'm like, the fucking hell it is, because...
That water.
We're right on the water. It's going to be like 56.
I hope we start at hole 7 this year.
I hope we start on hole 8. Well, we just get the 2 water holes out of the way.
Yeah, hear me out. You loosen up on that long par 5.
Oh.
And you're not freezing.
How about we start on hole 6? Can we agree on that? Because then I get a short par 4.
But then we end on a par 3.
Yeah. By that time, we should be nice and loose and hitting dirty draws right into the pin location. We already know where the pins are. It's Sunday. It's Wyandotte. Nothing's changed. It's always tucked behind the water.
You're right.
So I need the draw swing to be in.
That's true.
In fucking good form, good action there. I don't know. It's going to be a... It'll be a fun one, I think. We got to find a 4th. I was going to ask Mike, because he golfs at Wyandotte,
yeah.
But it's also Sunday, and he's going to be watching football.
Yeah.
That's the other downfall.
They waited way too late this year to do this one. It is normally in September.
Trying to think of who else I golf with that would say, fuck it, yeah, I'll golf.
I don't know anyone, like, local that's decent. I golf with them already.
Yeah. Like, it really sucks that he has to fucking work. Like, he would have been... I don't know what's going on with Andy. I don't remember. Like, he did get taken out in the game on Tuesday, but...
No, I mean,
if I can remember, like, he popped right back up and he played the rest of the game. He didn't look like he was hurt, but he got taken out. Like, the dude legitimately, it was almost like a slew foot from what I seen there, knee on knee. Like, he was either front facing or behind him. But,
well, if it's front facing, it's very avoidable.
Yeah, but I mean, we were playing the Wyandotte team, the Wyandotte Bears, basically.
The Bears.
I mean, Butler was their goalie, so. I still couldn't score on Butler. I don't know what he has. He has something. He knows my moves.
He was a junkie.
You can ask him, but I mean.
Do you have his number?
Yes.
Or better yet, like when you get a second, just blast the hockey groups. Like, we need a fourth for an outing and two.
Need a fourth outing. Why not? Be there by 1:30.
Why? Well, like, let's just get the yes first and then demand what time
Okay.
This might be our best bet because I think Machuckin would be solid enough.
Yeah. I mean,
and then we could have two Kevs and two Corys.
Is Corey Cart the Kev Cart?
I'll also crying in my car because my dad's yelling at me.
You want to put Machuckin with your dad? Sorry, we gotta channel to keep going. Dad, this is Corey. This is also Corey. You're going to be riding with this Corey.
Not to be confused with that Corey. That works too.
I mean, you know my password. I don't know why you're not just taking my phone and texting.
You need a fourth. Fourth. Outing. At. Two. At. 4422. And now we wait. We're out here doing a meat missile of the year. We'll call it a challenge. Right now it's a head-to-head battle between Lakes of Taylor, and you guessed it, located in Taylor, and Fox Creek, located in Livonia. We're driving right now. We're on 75 for, you know, the live feed sake, which this won't be posted for at least another 2 weeks, but hey.
We have fun. It's in the comments in all of our videos. We have fun.
Yeah, we have fun. So keep that in mind. We're going to go into tremendous detail, we'll say. We'll talk about buns. We'll talk about juice. We'll talk about bun-to-dog ratio. We'll talk about squirt in the back of the mouthfeel. We're just going to have fun with it. So stay tuned and enjoy the road trip.
There will be drinking involved too.
Sure.
I gotta have a drink. We have party favors for the outing, thinking that Andy was gonna be with us, so we might not even touch the birdie juice.
No, we'll go four under.
I think it's gonna be hard not to go four under. Is your dad gonna take shots with
him? Yeah. So,
all right, then no one's responding. We might have to call Corey direct.
It's still kinda early for the Friday night drinkers.
It's Sunday.
Wow. I've been drinking every day this week, so.
That's early for the Friday night drinkers. That would be true if it was Saturday, but it's Sunday. Although, we are all over 30.
Yeah.
So, hangovers last longer than just 12 hours nowadays, unless you hop back on the horse.
You don't call it 30 and over for nothing. The hangover takes about 31 hours to clear itself.
I've been there. You've probably seen it in some videos.
Yeah. On a side note, what dog are you most excited for? Out of the two?
I'm trying to remember. Was Fox Creek the one we did with Cowell?
Yeah. He said verbatim, this will be going head to head for number one at the end of the year.
And he wasn't wrong. Like, that's bold.
Who knew?
He also said that Lakes of Taylor was ass. He gave it a 12.
That was like my favorite dog. I mean, it shows at 17, but.
Yeah, I mean, I think, what did I rate that as? 16 or 17?
Yeah, and then we just had the round table debate.
Yeah.
What we'll do an average again, because it's back to me and you.
Yeah.
So if I go 18, you go 17, it's 7.5.
Yeah.
17.5. Yeah. you know what I mean.
18, 17, we're marking it as 7.5. Hold that dog, we couldn't agree. You're at the bottom now. Exactly.
Just like Taylor Mewdos. Oh my god, it went down to a 5 real fast.
Yeah, no, that's fair. I do. I'm honestly trying to remember the Fox Creek one.
It was early in the season because Andy wasn't here.
Yeah, it was when he used to have his gallbladder attack. Yeah.
This is like your third ever video.
This one might have been the one that was like. The bun was overly crunchy.
Yeah.
But the dog was really good. Or was the bun soggy?
Yeah, because I think your comments were, and then I'll put up the video in between this when we're doing the long video. I think you said if we had this dog last week's bun, you would have a 20.
Yeah, I think I think this was the one where the dog was really fucking good, but the bun itself was like crunchy.
Yeah,
and I dislike when you can't get any of the juices in the bun, and the bun's just like flaking off when I'm trying to bite into it. It's not good.
So, me and you are pretty aligned when it comes to that kind of stuff. But Cowell's, he's a rando, right?
Yeah.
He loves everything well done. He orders his pizza well done. He doesn't like to see any bread in his meat. It's to each their own. So, I think this one might have been inflated because of him. But, you know, since we're going in there right around peak dog time, a lot of groups are in the turn.
Yeah.
We might get a.
Or no groups are hitting the turn because it's fucking cold as hell outside in Michigan. True.
Do we even check if this course is open?
Nope. We did not.
But it had a restaurant, so it was fine. And Lakes of Taylor's always open.
Yeah, Lakes of Taylor only closes when there's snow on the ground.
That and their bar is always closed.
On Sundays, for some reason, the ideal spot to hang out and do stuff is closed.
All these river rats. Ain't that right? I want to say Jeff Coates. River rat. We got you.
Oh, yeah. What about him? We don't have his number. He won't see this video.
That's true.
Damn.
We can try to hit him up in the comments or something.
Answer me, please. Please. Still nothing, huh? God.
I need to see it.
Well, it also depends on if the guys stayed up late watching college football. I don't know how much you watch college football.
I just watch Michigan, really.
Yeah, so all your games are at noon.
Until the one time we play the lights.
That should be Michigan State, which ironically enough will be the weekend of your birthday and the weekend I am in Vegas.
That's fine. So, I'm a family. I don't need friends.
Yeah, but friends make it so much better.
You're not wrong.
Like, I'm so glad when they said that, because I think it was a toss-up between who Michigan was going to play in their lights between Michigan State and Penn State.
And Dave says you got to throw 100 on Michigan, which is a pretty good bet, but the rivalry is weird.
It is.
I might hedge and throw 20 on State.
Michigan fucking, for some reason, sucks against Michigan State.
Yeah.
But Michigan State is not playing good football on the defensive side at all right now. Michigan is really, I won't say really good, but they're good on offense. I don't know what happened in the first half of last game, like yesterday, because they were tied going into halftime with Indiana.
Yeah.
Not saying Indiana's bad, but it's Indiana. You should beat the piss out of them.
Yeah. I was a little scared because I was coming back from, we bought a couch actually.
Oh, you bought a couch?
Yeah. So
Matt Damon bought a zoo one time.
Oh, but my story's a lot quicker. We bought a couch.
Yeah.
It's going to take 3 months to get here because we customized it because we're bougie now. But so now the basement's going to have a really big opening and maybe it'll be a little more podcastable. We'll see. But I'm still open to decking out your basement too.
Yeah, I know. You want to dress up my basement?
I really do. Because I made this couch. It looks beautiful. With that being said, I think we had a good segue going on to bets. Did you make any bets this morning or last night?
I did not because my college parlays the last 3 weeks have really just hurt me terribly. I put just a Michigan parlay in and J.J. McCarthy let me down. Everything else hit, but his passing yards was nowhere near 260, which I should have known. I should have took the under, but...
What do you end up at?
This was, what, 3 games ago now, so... I think he ended up with 200 or 210. I needed him over 264 and a half.
Okay.
I thought they would air it out a little bit.
I was going to say, maybe it was that interception in the end zone that fucked you, but...
No.
That was a good, like, 25-yard pass, though.
Yeah. No, this was against Maryland. So,
oh, yeah.
It's a while ago. Like, I had the touchdown. I think I had Ronnie Bell scoring a touchdown. Or no. No, Roman Wilson scoring a touchdown. I had... Blake Corum scoring a touchdown. I think I had Michigan on the money line. And I had... Or did I have the... Oh, did I have Michigan covering the spread? Maybe that's where I found it. I know one or two of my legs just didn't hit. I did not place any bets today. There's still time, though. I don't really care about the 9:30 game. It's...
I did a couple. I did an easy parlay. Oh, man, if I wasn't using my phone to record this right now, it'd be a lot easier to remember. But it was straight favorites.
Oh.
Like, so nothing to really brag about. But I did do a 4-person parlay for anytime TD score. And we're running back heavy. Saquon, Derrick Henry, Kamara.
See, that's questionable. I tried that once. No. Derrick Henry's going to fuck you.
Yeah. He's on my fantasy team, so I'm going to root for him.
But, I mean, I'm rooting for him, too.
There's another stud running back out there that, like, should get into the end zone. That's playing today.
Jamal Williams?
Chubb. So it was Chubb, Henry, Kamara, and Saquon.
I don't dislike that. Saquon plays the morning game, doesn't he?
Yeah, I got it in at 9.
Yeah, they're starting right now. They should be starting. Maybe he's already scored.
Yeah, it might be on at Fox Hills here.
Yeah, Creek. I hope
Creek.
So.
Bills. Hey, on a side note.
Fox Creek.
Do you just want me to use all of this stuff for the podcast?
What stuff?
Like what we're talking about.
I mean, we can interject it, but I would like to see if Andy would like to have it at his house so we can still have the third person.
And he can talk about his injury.
Yeah, we can get an update on the injury, how that happened. Like I said,
because we got a lot of windshield time here, so yeah, we might actually have a really good podcast.
I remember him going down in our game Tuesday. Like, I looked over and like he was getting up and he was like yelling at someone and I couldn't hear him.
Well, he does that every game.
Yeah. Well, I mean, in fairness, we play a lot of people and there's a lot of teams that like they have that bum player. On our team, it's me. I get it, but I'm not as bad as them because I can try to avoid people where they have people who just run into you for the hell of it.
Sure.
And it always seems, I don't know what it is, if he's got a magnet in his like hockey pants or something, but they always run into Andy.
That's because he looks like Matt Giordano.
Like, they always run into him. No one else, like, everyone else is like, they bump into us a little bit, but they like run into him for some reason.
I don't know. Maybe he's just not big enough. Or like, I'm tall. You're big, and Andy's that like
he's that in between of like he's tall.
Get away with this one.
Like this one looks good. They don't go after the little guys because they're faster than them. So like I can't hit them anyways.
Yeah.
I get it. Yeah,
that might be it. I will say though, I was watching back that
I was watching the two videos you posted about Whispering Willows. And I hurt myself.
Yeah.
Started crying. Like the titles of the videos, Cousins wanted to smoke again. I'm watching, I'm like, I thought we would. Nope, yeah, because my big mouth, I lost that fuck. I wanted to punt last for the fucking win.
Yeah.
And I fucking didn't even get it anywhere near the hole.
Yeah.
What an asshole.
The videos are getting better, though. They're quick. They're snapping to each other. It's good. I need steadier camera work on my behalf, but we'll get there. Baby steps. But Westburn, when on hole 9, right before we hopped that group, and he's like, because I was like, no, you don't try all the time, Andy. And he's like, no, like ever since you said I did. I will say he's right. He's getting involved in the play a lot more. It's nice to see.
He is.
And I'll say this again while he's injured, looking like Charlie's grandpa.
He also, Willy Wonka. Yeah, I think, what are you doing, bud?
Guys, we almost died. How's my driving? Not good, asshole.
Fucking Christ.
But yeah, also, on a side note before you go on, I could totally use this as another podcast. Okay. I could just release this one first.
Yeah.
Because it's more relevant.
But no, he is also in, I think what's helping him try a little more. Once you kind of call them out. So
yeah.
He's gonna want to prove that, like, yes, I'm doing this. And I get that. And he is. He's jumping in the play a lot more on 30. On Sundays.
Yeah.
But on Tuesdays, he is legitimately, like, skating up. Like, he'll take the puck up. The puck might, you know, pop off his stick because...
That's right.
We play at Southgate and Lincoln Park, and the ice is garbage, even though it's literally high school hockey season right now, and still the ice is magoo. But he's taking it up more, and he's, like, he's getting into, like, an Ovechkin-type area now. Where,
as a defenseman.
Like, yeah, he's crashing down to try to get that backdoor pass.
I like that.
Whereas before, as you know, when we were playing, he would just kind of hang out at the point. He wouldn't go down.
Sometimes even the red line.
Yeah, like he wouldn't go down into the zone a lot.
Yeah.
Which, there's a sign that says no turn. We won't turn that line. Hell with you.
Yeah, it's definitely getting better, though. Yeah. I appreciate it.
And I don't know, other than losing weight, what I can do.
It probably didn't. Well, Humble Beach Pod.
That's on the docket, all right? It's supposed to be a January thing. It's still, what month is
give
it?
Give me
October?
I'll meal prep for you. Like, you give me, like, $50 for groceries, and you have to eat that for lunch every single day
It'll be
without fail.
Yeah, it'll be easy, especially with this new job.
because I'm gonna be working 1 to 9:30, so I can go to the gym in the morning before work, and then go to work, and I'll have the, you know, eat a healthier meal at work, and
just might slip into a depression.
I'm probably gonna slip into depression. It's not a failed thing. It's gonna happen. Corey, you look so much better. Why is your mood bad? Because I'm fucking depressed. That's why. What is that? God? What a...
Hey, now that we narrowed it down to two, though, we can totally just, like, I'll pick the bill up here and then you can fill up the legs. And...
All we need is a couple, you know, two drinks and two dogs.
Yeah. Is it a whiskey day?
I'm going to be jumping into some teas. I don't know what that's mixed with vodka. What do they mix tea with?
Well, it's a malted beverage, right? So it's like, what's White Claw? Because that's not vodka, but High Noon is vodka. So it's some type of blend.
Some type of liqueur, I would assume. It's definitely not beer.
Yeah. Because it's not
brewed,
I guess.
Yeah. I mean, it could be a whiskey thing. Who knows? I assume you're just always going with double Jack and Coke, so.
Well, single probably for the sake of marathon.
We have to golf later in hockey.
It's a caffeine thing that I do want. And I'm not sad hitting the turn right now, so I don't need to double.
You're going to be sad if no one fucking starts commenting on shit. Like, can we get a response?
Yeah, we're fucking. Now.
It's not even a response, it's a comment. Hit like, guys. Goddamn. Like the video. We need another golfer. I'm trying. Who else do I know that golfs that's decent?
I'm going to call my dad before we take off, too, to make sure everything's lined up. Because he might have someone that...
Oh, maybe.
Oh, we could even get Lynette out there.
I mean, that's
She's fun. Not great at golf, but she gets the tee off in the ladies' tees.
And we could use her putting.
I
don't know if she's good at putting. I've never golfed with your mother before.
No.
I've only golfed with your father one time, but I didn't really golf with him because I was in a group with Brandon and Steve and my dad, and you were with your dad and who else?
Lynette Molly.
Yeah. And that was back in 2012.
Yeah. Hey, side. Well, maybe in 2013.
No, it was 2012.
And then me and you went up there and golfed with Steve.
Yeah, and you guys put me with fucking Steve in a cart.
Yeah, why did we do that?
I don't know. I don't fucking know. I slept in my my Dodge Avenger that night, too.
I slept on a couch. Who knows? We'll leave that in because
probably
it's way before Kayla.
Probably some disease. Who knows? All I remember is waking up that day to Joey knocking on my window.
That's funny.
Like, hey, man, are you golfing?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm on my way.
You might want to, you know, get dressed.
I am dressed. Jokes on you.
I'll just do it in the car. It's fine. I'll stand up outside. Man, it's cold out here.
Oh, it was, wasn't it?
It was like this. It was a cold day. Why do people have golf outings in October?
Cheap rates.
Yeah, I mean, I get it.
But they still charge prime time for, like, a fundraising. So.
Yeah. I looked at that flyer you sent in the group chat. $40. I'm like... Think about it. It's like 30 to golf with a cart at Wyandotte, so fundraisers only get like $10, but they probably get a discount, so it's probably 20.
Yeah.
Probably 20 and 20 at that point. There's that damn humming again.
It's coming from here.
I don't know. We'll figure it out. If the car blows up, the car blows up.
Yeah.
It's a lease anyways. Maybe it's the thing. Oh, it could be this. Hitting the mount.
Maybe.
Yeah. But they were pissing me off down there.
If we do that. For you viewers, the culprit.
Potentially.
No, we're just going to blame everything.
It comes back. Who do I know that's a good golfer that I still talk to? I try to get rid of all the good golfers in my life.
That's because they're typically douches.
No, it's just because every time I golf with them, they want to try to fix something.
No.
In my game.
Yeah, just let me golf poorly.
Like, just let me be bad at golf. And let me be upset.
And then him. And then
I'm going to shut down, be bad at golf, be upset that I'm bad at golf,
and then still deny any request of help from anyone.
Hey, at least you know you have a problem.
Like,
no one's half the battle.
Yeah, fixing it is useless. I'm not going on tour. If there's any tour I'm going to get on somehow, it'll end up being, it's not it. It sounds like a phone is going off. Oh, we got a drink here.
I don't know. I really don't. Is it vibrating when you have to make? I don't know. I can't even make this up.
You know what? I don't care. Through the power of editing, you guys won't even hear this noise.
They probably won't in general. We're just freaking out. Oh my god, I'm so scared.
Something starts vibrating in my truck. It gets a little discouraging for a while.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Nothing. Yes.
It could be all the change. There's a lot of change in there.
It's such a weird vibrating noise, though.
It is what it is. We're fine.
Maybe.
We have fun.
We do have fun.
We have fun. I'm trying to think, golfers.
I'm losing my mind. Viewer.
Whichever one of you is viewing this right now, we're losing it.
We did get 13 in that past 5 days, though, which is crazy.
Yeah, where did that come from? And why did we take this way? I don't like it.
I don't know.
I just, like, I was so lost for a second. It's like you're turning in like a quarter of a mile. I thought we'd turn. I always turn left into the parking lot.
Yeah.
It was different for me. This was the place I hurt my wrist. I remember that.
Yeah.
Because I drunkenly fell off the fucking thing.
It's also the moon caramel day, too. That's 2 years ago?
Yeah.
That's something I do want to get better at, too, is getting more, like, cinematic, like, leading up to the golf course, and, like, that could be the intro, the walk-in.
Oh, we have arrived at our destination.
All right, so, initial thoughts, though.
I guess initially, the dog looks weird.
Yeah, I do get that gray.
Yeah. Tint. But it looks good at the same time. Like, it looks weird, but I think it's going to have a lot of juices. I think
That's true. Let's get it in our rotate. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Bun definitely feels better than the last time that I remember.
Okay.
So honestly, I think we just have to get into it.
Well, go ahead. Take your first bite.
All right. It's got good flavor. Bun is good. A little bit of a crunch to the bun, but still soft enough to where it's not like overly like dry.
Okay. Don't give me your number just yet. You're gonna film my reaction here.
Good temperature.
Okay.
Is lacking on the juices a little bit.
That's surprising.
Just a small amount.
Okay.
Like it's not like it's not there, but it's not like the last time when we were here when it was like.
Yeah, for sure.
So I think that's the only knock right now that I have.
Yeah.
Okay.
We're gonna ASMR this one. Oh. Okay. I gotta echo your comments. Do wish it was a tad bit juicier.
Yeah.
I do need a softer bun, I do.
Compared to the last time though, I think the bun's got it.
Very fair. It's better than the last time. Less grill marks, though. No grill marks, actually.
I didn't have very many either.
Yeah. All right, so we're going to flip it back to you. What do you think? This is for best dog of the year. Best meat missile, if you will.
Best meat missile. I think a couple more grill marks. Maybe the bun's a little...
Let's be maybe harsh.
They steam the bun a little bit instead of grilling it. Yep. I think that's a big thing.
Yeah.
This time around,
best I could do is probably 14.5.
14.5.
I respect that. That's the best I could do.
Good feedback. 14.5. I'm a sucker for a steam bun. I get it. Make it nice and moist, if you will. So I'm going to go as low as 13 on it.
That's fair. I was judging it. I still, it had a lot of good stuff there, but I don't think it's anywhere near the 16 or whatever we gave it the first time.
No, not even close. But again, it's game seven. We got to be harsh. So was that 13.75 there?
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that's the final here at Fox
Creek.
All right. So that was our first stop. Fox Creek, where the dog was lacking.
It was less of a dog. Kind of like an overboiled.
Yeah, so the dog, 13.75.
Although still, original ratings was in the top two.
Yep.
So
yep.
Maybe they just had a bad day today. I get it. Play as fuck up, I understand.
Well, hopefully we just get blown away by the meat missile at Lakes of Taylor. Because I don't want that one to win after that experience, if I'm being quite frank. Get it? Frank? Mic'd up. Reese's Puff, Reese's Puff. Okay.
But yeah, I don't know. That was definitely an underwhelming dog this time.
I will say, the ambiance was good.
Oh yes, loved the aesthetic.
It was a bar and grill. They didn't have too many offerings, but I bet you if we asked for like relish or something, they had it.
Oh yeah.
Great course. They already aerated. I don't know what else you got about that experience.
About that experience.
Yeah.
I do like the bars. The amount of TVs they have, it's going to be really hard to miss a sports
game. That's true.
So you could sit there all day and get drunk and watch sports.
That's important.
And eat mediocre hot dogs, I guess, today.
But they had a full menu, though. So
they do have a full menu, but we are only in for the dogs. We tried corn dogs. You guys didn't like it.
Yep.
Kind of upsetting. But, hey, we'll get it.
There's more to come on that, though. We got Polish meat. Missiles.
Gotta love Polish meat missile.
I might do a video where I get like 7 different brands of hot dogs, cook them all the same, and just try them plate for bite.
Yeah, I mean, I can tell you, based off of what I know about you, I know who's gonna win.
Who?
Koegels. Natural casing.
See, I would have went with Kowalski.
Koegels with the snap. You're a big snap guy. Damn. I get it.
I would have went Kowalski, the hometown Dearborn team.
I mean, you're not wrong. I should probably leave my keys in here so we don't turn the car off and maybe beep at me.
Or vibrate at you. I'm deflated.
Why?
We've had a mediocre dog.
Oh.
We have mediocre friends.
Oh.
Well, what about the lines that you want to talk about?
They're star-studded offense.
Yeah.
Which, I don't even know if you can call them stars, but man.
Studded.
They are definitely a bunch of studs. Their defense, though, god-awful. We'll say, Jeff Okuda has been playing very well this season on defense.
Yeah, I just don't like drafting cornerbacks that early.
No, I understand, and he really didn't, like, his first two seasons.
Imagine if we got Big Gay Slay and both of them and Dre Bly.
Oh, man. Old school Dre Bly. That'd be awesome. That dude was a monster.
There's another one somewhere in there, right? Forslay? But after Bly?
We had a safety that hurt our players more than he hurt anyone else.
I don't know if that's positive, but all right.
It's not, but I forgot his name. Defensively, no, not that I can remember.
Who do you think our fourth will be today? Let's start there. Because I know we're going to find some.
there's a solid possibility it ends up being your mom. I think, because if we can't find someone, then your dad's
going to start. How does Andy get in, like, so frequently?
Like I said, man, it didn't seem like it was all that much. I'd seen him get off the ice, but get up from the ice.
We would have done some work today. We 7 under minimal.
Oh, yeah. I mean, that's still technically not out of the question. If your dad is, you know.
He's been playing a lot. So
yeah, maybe. So he's probably on a good one. You and I haven't been playing bad, like in our scramble videos. We're not hitting bad shots. They're just not ideal all the time. What in the actual fuck?
Yeah, we really got to step up today.
Yeah, we're going to have to be on one. Like, the minute Andy sent that message to us, I was like, ah, shit, I need to stretch. I need to show up to this outing like I used to show up to outings where I was trying to prove to everyone that I was actually a really good golfer, even though I'm not. And like hitting these shots that you're like, how come you don't do that on a regular basis?
I want a whole 3 Willow Metro Corey self eagle.
Oh, yeah.
So we need.
Also happened at Carrington.
We're gonna eagle 9. I know that.
Yeah, 9 is without a doubt
birdies early and often.
Well, that's the issue. Is Wyandotte is that course where it gets easier as you progress through it.
You need to birdie 1 though.
You have to birdie 1.
There's no reason not to.
2 is what, the first par 3.
Yep.
That one par is okay.
Yeah.
3.
But like a chance at birdie, like a 20-foot putt, that's fine.
Yeah.
And if we miss that, we miss that.
3 we have to. 3 is par. I'm gonna say. I'm trying to remember how 3 goes.
It's that straight shot over the hills.
Yeah, 3 is par.
3 should be birdie though.
No, 4 is birdie. 4 is.
No, 4 is par because it's got that runoff at the back. That one's tough.
4 should be birdie without a doubt.
I think you're backwards, but all right.
Based off of you and I, no one has to hit, especially from the whites, has to hit driver on that hole to give us a shot inside 100 yards.
Right. I'm still going to hit driver.
I know you're still going to hit driver.
Never not going to hit driver.
We're playing the whites. I'm going to hit probably 3-wood. I'm going to play the safe shot, a chunk of 3-wood.
My dad's going to hit driver, and he hasn't figured that club out. Past year, so we'll see what happens. We'll see what KG1 brings.
I think in a perfect
world, Kevy would be 12.
We just bring him. 3 Kevins and a Corey. Here we go. In a perfect world, Rosen would just show up and golf with us.
Yeah, it's kind of obnoxious.
Now, what would he have done had you not gone and said, like, hey, I'm going to get Corey because I don't know if you're going to be back in time from your trip? Like, just not showing up and not told you guys, and you'd be asking me at 10 o'clock, like, hey, man, Rosen bailed. Can you golf? Like, hope to God Corey's not already in the bag because there's a 9:30 football game.
Well, next year, assuming Andy goes injury-free, I think we win it. We came in second the past 2 years.
Yeah, but that's with Angels. Yeah. Honestly, I don't see how we can come in second.
And not you last year, too, so that could have been a game changer.
I mean, this year, Rosen and Corey are probably similar, but last year, Rosen, I would say I was better than him.
You took a decline. I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's just a mentality thing. But
could be the camera. I don't know. I play.
We're focused on the content.
I play so well. Like, the time I went and played at the Legacy with Z and Cotner and their other – what's the other guy's name?
I forget, but I know what you're talking about.
Plays hockey with you guys.
Yeah. Well, I got cut, so.
Yeah, well, he plays hockey with Brandon because you got cut. I shot an 87 there. And like, I played good golf.
Rosen wouldn't even sniff 80s in there.
Like, I just played good golf while I was there. And that was the worst score in our foursome was 87.
That's wild.
Like, Cotner and Z, I think, both shot 80. And the other guy, I think, he shot 83. And like, yeah, the shit score was 87. Like,
good year.
That's a solid group of fucking golfers right there. Your bad score is an 87. I'm okay with that.
Yeah, for sure.
Or like when I did the Graham McKay Invitational. I shot, my team shot 3 under, 4 under, 3 or 4 under. What one? I think 5 under 1. I shot 3 under. Yeah. But I was golfing with a guy that was like 80 years old and another guy who had just started golfing this year. So,
yeah.
Relied heavily on a lot of Corey shots.
I think this is a common theme because in my workouting, we shot, I think, 6 under. Someone who's decent at golf, me and 2 non-golfers. So, like, mentality.
Yeah.
Go out there and shoot your best score. It doesn't matter what ball you use, but you're just there to shoot the best score.
I think that's what we do. Even if we can't find a fourth, we just run 3 at this point.
They'll probably be better.
I think we just have to go out there in this outing with this.
Maybe we could rock a ghost golfer.
Like, with the Mamba mentality, as you called it last week.
Yeah. Didn't help.
Didn't. But, like, go out there with a Tiger Woods or a DJ trying to win his first major or Rory as of, like, the end of the season where he was just shooting great golf. Like, he was playing great golf.
I want 2015 Jordan Spieth.
Have that motherfucker, because he almost got the career Grand Slam in 1 year.
Yeah, that's what I want.
Like, go out there and just play every round like we're going to win $1 million. I don't even know if we win money in this.
And you get a trophy.
I want the trophy.
I want another long drive is what I want.
I'll back off.
No, we all chase. I want our group to be top 3.
I got to change my driver setting before we get there.
To what?
Well, because when I try to hit the draw, I never get it out right enough, even though I'm aimed so far right. I think
it's just swing path.
It is. And it also has to do with, like, my club face is already coming in square. That's why it's like coming straight. Around. And then I'm still hitting the draw. So it's like a hook.
Yeah.
I want to put that weight that I have in my driver all the way in the heel. So it keeps that face open so long that I force the ball to go right.
I think there's another word for it because it's not a hook.
I mean, it's a draw. I'm just pulling the ball.
Right. Is a pull draw thing?
Yeah.
Because that's what it is.
Yeah, that's I need to get it out.
A hook would be you start it out way mark.
Yeah. Not Panini.
I mean, you can blow that smoke in here. I'm fine with it. What's it going to do to me?
It smells delicious. If you were into these, I'd let you want to hit it. You can. But it's so good. It tastes like bubblegum. Yeah.
It's like a bubble tape almost.
Yeah, like bubblicious. Yeah.
Maybe it's Big League Chew.
Grape? No, it's not grape.
Not grape, but
it's tropical, but it's fucking good. I don't know. Kevin had it. He's like, dude, try this. Okay. Oh, that's a delicious tasting one. I do find it odd. I know we've talked about this, just never on camera.
Perfect time.
That 2 of the 3 Kevins that I know, one I live with, and one I create content with, were born on the same day.
Yep.
It's weird. What are the odds of that?
Do you know Kevin Dunn? Recently passed. Went to Trenton.
No.
His birthday was October 30th.
Really? I don't know when Butler's birthday is, but I swear to God, if it's in October sometime, I'm going to lose it.
I don't know. He strikes me as like a September guy.
I don't remember when his birthday is. I'll tell you what, though.
My kid's birthday is January. My dad's August, so opposites.
But yeah, I don't. It was just weird. Like, oh, yeah, my birthday's the 31st. Of what? October. What the fuck? How do I know 2 Kevins?
Same day.
Same, you know, same birthday. Only difference is he was born in 86, 87.
Still.
One of them.
Austin Vanilla Ice.
Yep.
And I think Willow Smith, too.
Yeah. Unfortunate.
And then someone else, like Houdini, maybe? Someone random like that. Man, those birds are cooking.
South is this way, guys.
Family.
One of you shits on my car while I'm driving, I'm going to be pissed. It's getting to that time where I don't want to take it to a car wash. It's getting too cold. I don't need my doors freezing up.
Apparently, the one right by Meijer offers you a membership where it's like $5 a month for unlimited car washes.
Oh, that new one, that fancy looking one?
Yeah. The one Elon Musk built?
Yeah.
I really don't know how, like, should I make this a 30-minute video and just, like, have good conversation back to, because most of the conversation is going to be the video.
I mean, we can sprinkle, I don't know if we're making a 30-minute video, because the dog reviews are only going to take, what, 5 minutes a piece?
So maybe post the whole thing edited as a podcast, but only do a 10-minute, like, what's relevant to, if something's funny. Keep it in for the YouTube sake.
Yeah. I'm thinking, like, if we got 5 minutes for, because a lot of our banter, like, it was like a 2-minute segment for each of us for the dog rating.
It was like 4 minutes in total, that whole
rating. So that's 4 minutes.
You shoot an intro. You shoot an intro per course.
But that can go in for that course's dog rating.
Yeah.
So main five, intro, five, so you're looking at 5.5. So you're looking at 12 minutes, and we could throw in maybe...
one-liners?
Yeah, just random stuff from this banter that we have going to the courses.
Yeah.
And just get that going.
And then episode 5 podcast. I don't even know if we're going to have time to shoot one today. We might have to, like, reschedule for tomorrow or something. Because we'll get to the course at noon. A little bit before, do all that stuff, shoot all the glamour stuff. I'll be home by 12:30, and then we gotta be at the course an hour later.
Yeah. God, this took a turn for the worst.
It really did.
If only I didn't have to stop for a fucking.
I mean, that added 5 minutes.
I'm thinking maybe.
But.
What are the chances we can try to convince Andy to get to the hockey rink? Maybe shoot the podcast there?
Slim.
I do, yeah, because he's going to be on crutches. I don't.
We can do another parking lot one, though, but we got to be more mic conscious because it sounded pretty bad.
Yeah, it definitely didn't sound great.
It made more sense if you watched the video.
Yeah, but if you're just listening,
yeah,
you're probably just going to...
barely on it.
Yeah, well, then he was trying to have other conversations when...
Yeah.
That's what I think. Like, I don't mind having those, like, here and there, sparingly.
I just don't know what to do today, because we're due for one on Tuesday. Unless you just want me to upload all of this and call it good.
I mean, I guess at this point we can see it. We can text Andy, see if he wants to do one tomorrow. After I get out of work, you get out of work. Hopefully it's not a late day for me. Maybe we can get over his house. Because I doubt he's going to be able to...
And that'd be fine. Because we could do a quick hour. Like, we already have the script. We can fine-tune it. Shoot. Get out. And then sometime in the future, we need to look at that podcast equipment. I have no idea what to do. I don't know if we need a computer hooked up to it or what.
We might.
So that...
We'll probably need software. Probably get free software and whatnot, but... I think it might even be... I think once we figure it out, it might be easier to use that stuff rather than like this, because we'll already have software you're using to edit all the podcasts. If we can have the mics plugged in and it's already recording all that, then all you have to do is just add the video in.
Yeah, and the video, like, I can do that separately. I just really need the audio to upload to Spotify and all that. And that... It's actually really easy. Like, we can still film and whatever my phone picks up will just be the audio for the video. But if I could separate those two things, it would make my life so much easier.
Yeah.
Because I would just pull the literal audio, maybe chop it up if there's a lull, send it. Because right now, I'm cutting the video, the MP4 into an MP3 in 10-minute segments and then uploading it. And on two mics, it's double the data. So
Yeah, I think once we figure it out, that's something we're going to have to
dedicate some time to.
Maybe use, like, maybe bring your laptop and have the program capturing the mics in the background so we can pull up the script on your laptop.
Yeah, that'd be cool too.
Like we did the first one.
Yeah.
Something like that. But that's going to be something where we might actually have to go to Andy's tomorrow anyways and see if he can figure all that out.
Yeah. Well, yeah, we just need confirmation for him, and I'll get everything ready to go.
Again, if he is willing to, like, try it, like, give it a go, maybe we do film. We have this one, obviously, no matter what.
Yeah, it's in the hopper.
Yeah. So if we can't get over there tomorrow or Tuesday to film the podcast, well, Tuesday would be too late. But
I just got to shoot, like, a random, like, intro of, like, hey, welcome to another Humble Beach podcast. We're going to do something a little different today.
Here's
We're taking you on a road trip to the Meat Missile is what I'm going to do.
Yes, road. Get our ad read in.
Yeah. I'm thinking about pre-shooting that anyway.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of, like, we keep going back to, like, Bob Does Sports and all that, but they have, like, pre-shot ad reads where it's something they
do. Like the Chiclet style where they just read it in the moment?
I don't dislike the pre-stuff, like the pre-made ones.
It's easier to edit if you do it in the moment.
Yeah, and that's the thing. But, like, we could randomly, like, just chop the video and just it goes to a picture or screen of you doing the ad read.
I'd rather do that for our own ad read, though, so we could, like, really shoot a commercial.
Yeah.
Terrence says we'll go to the molehill.
I was going to say that, but I don't know if he understands that.
I would assume so. We watched a lot of movies growing up.
Okay, everything just went black. That's not good. All right. So he's checking on Jake. I would rather have, like, the extra shot, though, for sure.
Yeah, I mean, Jake's not going to be bad. Going to Wyandotte, I think Jake will be fine.
I've never seen him golf.
I'm going to have to tell him right away, like, look, dude, you don't need to be the best version of, like, golfer that you are. I just need you not to suck.
Seems interesting way to put that.
Like, just go out there and have fun. We're going to golf a little bit. We're going to take some drinks to the head.
Oh, yeah. To the soul.
I'm going to fucking, you know, bring your own shit. Or do you need, I don't even need. Jake's 23. Jake's 23. He can buy his own shit. Grab a sixer. On the way, and then, you know, we'll fucking
give her
hell, kid. Like, go out there. We're out there to have fun, but shoot well. We're not out there to shoot 10 under par.
That's the only problem, though, is one team always brings a Wayne State golfer. Not that that's scary or anything, but
he's a college golfer.
That's all it comes down to. Like, they won last year. They were 7 under.
Well, that's the thing, is, like, I was going to call a guy that I used to golf with who went to Mercyhurst College and golfed there.
Yeah.
And he usually shoots, I think his handicap's a 2 right now. Although every time I golf with him, he shoots like 8 over. But, you know, I don't know how handicaps work. I'm not that smart. But he's a solid golfer. Like, he's very rarely gets in trouble off the tee. He can maneuver.
Which is huge already.
Yeah.
In a scramble format.
Yeah. Like, and he hits the ball farther than I do, and he's a little guy.
So is Will Zalatoris, and I would argue he fucking spanks that ball.
Not little that way. Little, like, short. Like,
Rory's, what, 5'10"?
I call him a midget. I don't think he's taller than Rory. I think he's, like, 5.
Can Z outdrive you?
Z and I usually compete. Z will outdrive me, and I'll outdrive him. But Z's also got the way Z swings, it looks weird. Like, it doesn't look like it should work, but Jesus Christ, when he connects with the ball, the thing fucking goes.
Baseball.
Kid's just a solid golfer, like, solid golfer between baseball, and he grew up playing hockey, too, although I think he was a goalie, so it's kind of irrelevant.
He was a forward.
He was a forward? Oh, okay. I thought he played goalie.
Nope.
Oh, you know what?
I actually played with him when I was, like, 4, playing with the 6-year-olds. And then I kind of in high school, but he got cut. So,
yeah, but, like,
no offense.
He, like,
Cowell got cut too.
He he's just another one of them, like, Bobby-type athletes where they're good at fucking everything. Like, Z's good at basketball. Z's good at, I would assume he's good at volleyball, but...
As a random number two, you went with volleyball.
We do, back when I was, you know, working with Mike and all them, we would go to volleyball and do that. And Z would show up, and he's good at that. Bowling, he wasn't bad at bowling. Like 180 average, I think, which is right around a men's average.
I would say that's above average.
If you're in a league, your starting average, if you haven't had
that's a league. Are we in a golf league?
We used to be.
It used to be. I'm saying, like, when you take a national average, it's not based on league.
All right. I see you.
I would argue, like, it's probably even lower because a lot of people are sub-100 bowlers.
At that point, they're not considered bowlers. They're just leisure.
So if you're over 100, are you not considered a golfer?
Depends on how often you get out. That's how I
once a week. What if you bowl once a week and you're still not over 100?
You should probably not bowl in a league at that point because you're going to just give away money.
So you're saying if I never broke 100, I should just quit golf?
No, because I've watched you break 100. I've watched you break 90. You've shot in the 80s before. So you're agreeing with me, but you're not agreeing with me. You're just doing this to argue with me.
Yeah. I am. You got me.
I'd be like, if you shot 3 games of bowling, like that's what a normal league night is. You have 3 games.
Well, I listen to my coach.
Yeah, your coach isn't stupid, so you got that going for you.
That's weird, because if you rewind the tape to the, 40-minute mark, they would say, I don't know how handicap works. I'm not that smart.
Yeah, golf handicap, not smart.
You said in general, because I'm not smart.
I bowled in leagues with people. I mean, one of my averages was a 170. That was bad. It was also when I hurt my wrist and I quit bowling for a while. So there are flaws to the system, but there are some people that will go out there and they'll shoot, you know, 150s, and that's their average, which is good for them, I guess, if they've never shot in the 150s consecutively like that. But it sucks when you got to bowl against them because of handicap. Like, handicap and bowling is the same as dealing with handicap and golf. It just sucks.
Hey, where are we going to eat this hot dog, by the way?
I don't know. Hopefully the bar's open. If not, we're going to sit out in the cold.
Right on the patio.
Right on the patio. Take some nice glamour shots of that. And
we could go over to the practice screen, the one that no one uses.
The chipping one?
Yeah.
I feel like I said that earlier.
Oh, that's what you meant?
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
After we eat the dog, I feel like we can just walk over there.
We can probably even just take a cart.
No, they give you keys. Watch we get here and the doors are closed.
We won't just eat the dog on that green.
We won't?
No. Okay.
I'm just going to ask them if they're patio there. Is the bar open upstairs?
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to go upstairs because that would be the place to have the glamour shots because you can see
everything
right on to 18. 18, or was it 18? Is that 18?
Yeah. You can see on the 9 as well.
Yeah.
You can see off of 10 and off of 1 as well, too.
It's just that's the place to be.
I mean, you can actually get up there regardless because they have stairs on the outside.
It's true.
So we can go up there.
Just eat the dog outside real quick and then run up top and take our glamour shots.
And then just do a recap on the way home for in conclusion. And then I'll get that engraved. And then I'll do like some type of like display, probably just in my backyard or something. I don't know. Or maybe next golf course we're at, because who's going to know? And then
the next golf course we're at is Wyandotte.
And it won't be engraved by then.
So I'm saying hockey tape, white tape. Black Sharpie. Like some Taylor 2022 Meat Missile of the Year. And you got to engrave the rating on it.
Ooh, touche. Good point. Do you want a regular season rating?
No, I want the championship rating.
because they are going to get progressively lower.
Yeah. I just want, what is the top dog score? What did we rate the top dog?
Something to consider. We could do an out of 20 system, but you add our scores together. So
mine's out of 10, yours is out of 10. Add them together?
Yeah, we could do that.
That would be more than, no, it wouldn't, I guess.
Because
the most it could be is 20. Yeah. We could do that. I'm in for that. But then how do we do it if there's a third person?
It's our show.
Just irrelevant if Kyle's.
But we could get an honorable mention to see like what they think. We could let them go first to see if they can make a case, something like that.
Yeah, okay.
Because that way, I mean, sure, it kind of skews this first one.
Did we not turn this off?
No, it's just texting. That would kind of skew the first year, but that's fine. That would just say, like, we both gave it a high six.
Jake's out.
Fuck.
Jake said he isn't available till 4. Sorry, mate. He also said, yeah, that's fine with me to come over and do the pod tomorrow. So we have that.
Are we out of options? Well, Majunkin didn't text me back yet.
Right now, I'm just racing the ambulance that's chasing us.
I have to because we're here.
This guy on my ass needs to slow the fuck down, though. I like how the person in front of the ambulance isn't moving. Comedy show at Taylor Meadows. Yeah, Taylor Meadows is a comedy show.
Look how busy this place is.
All right. We're here live at Lakes of Taylor doing the last of the doubleheader here. Checking out the meat missile. We're going to flip it over to Corey and see what he thinks. Here's the first opening.
All right. Bun presentation. Nice soft bun.
Oh.
No grill marks. Well, kind of burn mark, I guess. Roller mark?
Roller mark, for sure.
Call it a roller mark.
Okay, love it.
It's honestly, this might be hard to beat. It's just off first, like, just feel. I haven't even tried it yet. I think it's going to be a top tier dog.
I sure hope so. Give her a bite, big dog.
All right. Bun, definitely softer.
Yeah.
Good bun. Good tasting dog. No extra juices.
Really?
I just...
You seem disappointed.
Looks can be a little deceiving, I guess.
Okay.
It definitely looked like it was going to be top tier, but there are some negatives there.
Okay.
I'm going to let you try to figure out what they are.
Okay. Let's see. Maybe mine's just better looking. Oh, it's upside down. Great start. Real juicy. Well, that's nice. That's nice. I'm just going to go in blind here. Don't even want to talk about it just yet. Uh-oh. This is not the same dog that we once had. A little dry. I'm wondering if it's because it was sitting in the warmer a little too long. Less snap. One's flaking apart, but still, you know, it's steam, so that's good. Man, that's tough. Decent flavor. I think the other one did have better flavor.
Yep.
Huh. I'm at a loss for words. I was expecting to just get juiced right in the back of the throat per my last comments in the last video. But I'm going to go ahead and just roll into my rating here.
All right.
Out of 20. I think I have to say it does taste better, I will say, and it does look better. The bar's closed, so that's got to be a point deduction. I'll give it a 14.5.
Bar is close, which is definitely a point deduction. Price point, though, we got the same thing at both places. Only difference was is you had a tall at the last one, and I had a short.
Right.
So I actually used less pop
on
mine at the last place. Yep. And it was still $4 less.
Touche.
For the whole kit and caboodle here. Now,
you have to factor in tip too. We actually had a server
Yeah, the server.
I did tip $4.50, but I assume you still tip at the last place.
Significantly, because I'm too nice.
Yeah. Now, dog looks better than what I assume was a beaten rabbit at the last place.
Ooh, the disrespect.
Like, it looked bad. Taste, I would say this one slightly, not much, slightly better taste-wise.
Okay.
Bun is flaking, but significantly softer. I'd have to agree. I would put it somewhere between 14.25 and 14.5.
Let's call it 14.5 just so the math will be really easy.
Yeah, okay, that's fair.
So, you heard it here first, and maybe even last. The meat missile of the year goes to Lakes of Taylor at 14.25 for its final playoff rating. It's been a great season. I'm honored to give Lakes of Taylor this blessing. We'll do a little shoot for them once I get this engraved, but kudos to you guys.
So, yeah, green light, we're good.
With all that being said, we just wrapped up the video.
We did.
Congrats to Lakes of Taylor, I guess, you know. It was a pretty soft playoff.
It really was. It wasn't the hard-hitting playoff I think everyone was looking for. It was more of the Lakers are in the championship again. No, they just dominated a team.
But they didn't even dominate either.
No, it was kind of embarrassing.
It was like that Rams versus Cincy, I guess. But still, that exact. I don't know.
I don't know if we've had two bad teams play off for the number one
spot. But we've had bad games.
It's very rare that I'm going to see both teams have a bad game at the same time.
It was last week. Tampa versus Green Bay. It was 13-10.
Oh.
That's what that was.
Oh, you know what the bad game was? And I hate to say it. It was Thursday Night Football. That's what we just watched.
We
lived that.
We absolutely had a Thursday Night Football showing for these dogs.
Like, the fact that Indy won on 4 field goals because my kicker only had a chance to kick 3 field goals for 122 field goal yards.
Yeah.
And they lost the game. Because both of those offenses are terrible.
And they're both horses. Broncos and Colts.
Yeah, well, go figure.
That was brutal.
The fact that I had to pay for Amazon Prime to watch that abomination of what they want to call a football game, ridiculous.
Well, things to consider. Do you think there is a peak season for the meat missile? Do you think October's too late to run the playoff?
I don't. It's a hot dog.
Yeah, but like...
Golfers want hot dogs.
I don't know.
Hot dogs want to be eaten by golfers.
But in cold golf, people are just trying to play golf and go. I don't even think it's cold.
It's 64.
It's really embarrassing. That's another thing. Like, everyone's out there.
Bundled up. Yeah. Like, granted, I can't say much because I'm wearing the same thing that everyone else was wearing out there.
No, they had beanies too.
Yeah, I don't have
one guy gloves.
I don't even want to wear this right now, but I just don't want to take it off because then I have to carry it. I don't want to carry it.
It's your aesthetic, too.
Yeah. Plus, it's holding my mic, so I got to keep it on for now.
That's true. But that was just embarrassing. And the other course, at least no one was golfing, so no one could.
I mean, I think there were people golfing. They just weren't anywhere near the clubhouse.
Which is weird because we tee off at 8, let's say, 2 hours to play the front nine. We should have seen at least one group at the turn.
Oh, we tee off at like 7.
And not in fall. Mostly because Andy's lazy. Speaking of which, he's out of commission. Like for the do you want to go golf, me and you? Like, how do you want to do this?
Like I said when we were texting, I think maybe
we could fuck around in Southfield and do all the fun challenges that
we do the dumb stuff, or we go do putt putt. We still have time to do putt putt for a little bit.
I think we could do both.
I think we could honestly make, depending on what time our hockey game is next Sunday, we could do 9 holes at Southgate and just film the whole
thing. We could do 36 at Southgate.
I don't want to do 36 at Southgate, but I'm saying like...
But what we could do first 6, I'll go ladies' tees, you do tips. Next 6, same thing.
There are no ladies' tees at Southgate.
There are? I thought they were like in the middle of the fairway.
There's like 2 sets of tees. There's the front tees or the back tees, and they're in the same tee box.
Not always.
86% of the time they're in the
Then we'll do random club. 6-hole random club, 6-hole one club only, 6-hole.
I got an idea. If it's just going to be us two.
Yeah.
we do three hole, one club challenge out of your bag. Yeah, three hole, one club challenge out of my bag.
I have a better idea.
All right.
Strip golf.
I'm out. I like my idea better.
Well, like, you could, I could just be in my boxers by hole six, and that'd be hilarious.
I want to wind up naked somehow.
I don't know.
I already don't golf with shoes on.
There's gonna be a lot of pushes. Maybe we both take something off for a push,
or
we'll workshop
the next hole. You got to take two items off.
Yeah.
I think that's a midsummer type of thing.
I think it'd be more fun when it's cold though.
My nipples are already hard enough through four shirts.
And that's what I'm saying. Like, wear an undershirt, a shirt, and a hoodie, and that's three holes right there. And then you don't have to worry about the pants. And then you could use the shoes. Like, there's ways around it. But, again,
we'll workshop it, all right? Yeah.
But, all right, so
we also can't do, like, full nudity.
Oh, I know, sure, but, like, boxes would be fine. That's like saying you can't do any, like, summer videos.
Yeah.
So, regardless,
we random club generator, you spin it.
Yeah.
Whatever club it lands on, you grab that out of your bag. We both use it for three holes.
Same exact club.
Yep. Yeah. If it's your 7-iron, we both use your 7-iron for three holes. Running this red light.
But I don't know. I think you should do it like every hole, though.
You want to spin it every hole?
Yeah.
And just rotate who gets. Yeah. We can do a 6-hole. You spin on the first holes. I go second.
Or we could even do
fourth, fifth, sixth.
We could even do like every shot if we wanted to. So it's always a different club, different bag.
Yeah, we can do that. Do we do a scramble format then to see how good we are? With shit clubs and shit luck, because neither of us have good luck.
No, we gotta do matches.
Uh-huh.
We have enough. How low can we go? And I don't want to know how low I could go at Southgate, because it's probably gonna hurt my feelings. I shot a 72. Is that good?
It's not. It's great if you're not playing at Southgate.
Yeah, so I don't know. I think the matches that way would be a little more fun and a little more shit talky and a little more interactive.
We have plenty of shit talk.
I know, but like, if we were like actively rooting against the other person,
you guys shit talking me mostly,
and that's when we're on the same team.
Yeah, that's when we're doing a how low can you go 4-man scramble.
Yeah, true. So,
yeah, I mean, we could workshop that. I think maybe
because we get a good, we could even do Fellows Creek one these days, and I could get two of my work buddies, and we could do Expeditors versus us.
But you are Expeditors,
right? But like, they bought the shirts.
So it's a 3-on-1.
But they bought the shirts, so they're like fans.
Oh, they're the ones that bought. Okay, I'm in. Call them up. Let's
do
it.
So we can do a fan challenge?
Let's do it next week. We can book the tea time.
Well, my buddy's on a honeymoon, so I don't know. I'll find out when he's back. But the first week of November is probably the most realistic for them. That's dicey, but I think it would be cool.
We could also do Expeditors versus Bogey or Humble Beach at X Golf if it's too cold. We could just go there, pay for two teams to do a scramble format.
Yeah.
Or even if we just say alternate shot. At that point, we could do alternate shot. That way we're not four balls going off.
Even so, we could probably just get Tim out, which would be one of them. Then we could run three. Or maybe he could be the fourth, like if we get Rosen out.
Yeah. I mean, like, he bought the merch. He paid for the merch.
Yeah, so he could be in a video, you know.
Yeah.
He also gave me the podcast equipment.
Maybe we pay for him to golf.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I would definitely do that.
I mean, did we spend all the shirt money?
Yeah, in that one round.
It was $100 for us to golf.
Oh, I lied then. Regardless.
I'm assuming you sold the shirts for 20 or 25.
Yeah, it was 20. But
so that's $80.
Yeah, so I have $20 to spend on golf. But
that, I mean, that should cover his...
Courses, especially
yeah, courses are coming down in price now because of the time of season it is. So
yeah, everything's aerated.
Yeah,
even Thorn Hills was like 21 or something weird. But yeah, it's nice to know that some shirts are moving.
I do appreciate that, and I will, if he wants more stickers, once she gets everything set up in her house, I think is when things are going to get booming again.
Yeah,
and hopefully I can get her to make more stickers for us.
He's kind of like, I don't want to say like pushing it for us, but he does disc golf every Thursday and he's got a big group of people. So I kind of want to like hook him up with some like second drop too.
Second?
Just so we can start talking about it.
That's not, or at least, you know, if we get the idea, like once you get your shirts, once I get my shirts, you and I
Sit down.
And Andy, sit down.
Yeah, good call. I already skipped Andy.
You, me, and Andy, and we get Beth to sit down with us four, and we kind of map out like what we want on what shirts. Because I don't want to drop a whole bunch of shirts.
Right.
I want a few shirts. A long sleeve shirt, a t-shirt,
yep.
And maybe another golf polo, which is why I got a golf polo.
See, I was thinking like a Q-zip.
So like what I'm wearing right now?
Yeah.
I don't have anything for her to print on, though. Did you give her something?
No, not Q-zip.
But I'm thinking like at least get an idea of what we want to see.
Yeah.
And then maybe give him those designs. Like, hey, man, it's not out yet. They're in the works of trying to get all this stuff put together.
Exactly.
And like
point.
The idea of like, yeah, we don't have the shirts for him to wear.
Yeah.
But if we can get him like a picture of what the shirt will eventually be, you know, and even get his input. I don't care.
Well, he likes how this color isn't like gray and it's like,
yeah, it's not white. It's yeah. not gray. It's like a gray, yeah. creamy beige.
He likes the like funky color that yeah. you don't always see. I am going to like, this is just on me. I'm going to go get a crew neck because he's golfing well into November. So he could like have the crew neck and then the tee under it when it gets warm. So I just don't know what logo I'd put on it yet.
I think that would be, crew neck to me just screams whiskey glass.
Well, he's already got the shirt, the whiskey glass.
That's true. So
I was thinking like college print.
All right.
Humble. And then you. Humble you.
Okay.
The simulation just went bad, but you're the best I ever had. Like Cam Prince and